tarnation.
All right, I'm back here at the Buck Hunter again, night after the party, and it's not working. No pump. So I'm gonna pull it out, take it back to the office, see what the problem is. Stay tuned. And you know how long it's been? I've been stuck playing Whac-A-Mole.
I'm getting ready to attack. Fanny pack attached. Tokens are all stacked, got the mallet in my grasp. Waiting for the moles, ha, hiding in their holes. Score, we're keeping tally, I'll be playing till they close now. Can't nobody beat my high score. You can't beat my high score. Can't nobody beat my high score. You can't beat my high score. I'm a mallet master, a single-fisted blaster. You can ask my baby. Starts slow, then gets faster. I'm a record setter.
All right, sorry about that little intro. It's hard to hold a phone in your hand and film and pump a shotgun and talk. It's so loud out there. So this is like the second time within a week for sure that we've been back on the Buck Hunter gun. I just want to start out this video. I don't know what's wrong with it. I have all the screws out of it, but I don't know what's wrong with it yet. I haven't actually cracked it open. I just want to kind of go over a few tips that'll make it a little easier to do this. If you know ahead of time or if you plan ahead of time. I'm trying to get this screw out. This one's always a pain in the butt. So one of the main things I want to say is there are two different size screws in this shotgun. Most of them are going to be one size. Let's see, that's the one. Most of them are this size. And then in the barrel of the shotgun, you have these shorter ones. So I just want to mention this because if you go to put one of the shorter ones down here in the stock or in the grip or something like that, yeah, it's not going to work out for you and you're not going to have enough short screws to go up here, and you won't have, you know, your number will be off. But I don't think they'll go in over here, and your long screws are too long to go in here. So, well, maybe you probably can't get a short one over here. But anyway, what I'm trying to say is just know that you have two different sizes, kind of keep them separate. I have mine in my little dish over there, but I know that I only have two short ones left. I know they're over here. The other thing is, this is just something I started to do within the past couple days. I started labeling my bits and my tips because I'm having trouble remembering what games they go to. And then I'm putting just a piece of tape with that color and writing the name of the game on there. That's not something game specific for this. That's just something I've been doing to help myself. Now on this, this isn't going to be permanent. That tape's going to wear off opening and shutting it. You can see this green for jumping jackpots already about to come off. But that's another little handy tip. The other one is I always, you can zip tie it or twisty tie it. I twisty tie the little one, but this ends up being a big mess when you're trying to flip the gun around back and forth. But I twisty tie this. And then I zip tie this one with a big heavy one. They're cheap enough. I'd rather do that than deal with the cord flopping around, dragging the gun off. And then there's one more tip I'm going to show you, but it's actually attached to the game at the moment. So I'm going to stop here. We'll cut in, and I'll tell you about that piece. And then we'll come back to the gun. So we'll be right back. Okay, this is the other piece I wanted to show you that was attached to the game. I made this so that I could pull the gun and put this in its place, and kids can't put anything through the hole or stick their hands in there or get a hold of any wiring because they will try. I just mount this in place of this. And this works on several different gun games that have this style harness and stuff.
So it's just a hard plastic, but it just helps that I can pull the gun, walk away from it, and, you know, do the repair on the gun another day, but the game can stay up. Whereas if I leave the gun on there and it's broken, we have to take it out of service. So this can save you a little bit of time to, you know, get to the repair while the game's in service, still making money. Continue.
I'll never do that on camera. All right, so let's see. We had nothing out of this gun. It sounded like the micro switches were working, but nothing was happening. So we got this little doodad is out of place here. Okay, so the same thing as the other day on the pump. See this little white rubber washer. This thing is in the wrong spot, and it should be all the way in the front to give us the resistance when we're pulling the pump to hit the micro switch properly. These little plastic guys, I think this one goes here. I forgot I'm zoomed in. Let me zoom in quite that much. Okay. So yeah, this little black rubber guy goes here. Now, this was a problem. Like, we had to just fix this, but it wasn't the only problem. Okay, I can hear it. It's actuating. We just tested this the other day, so I know it's good. And this is plugged in. See if it's clicking. Gonna have to test it too, though. It sounds okay to me. This was supposed to be the other way around, I guess. It's not fitting in there the right way. And I gotta figure out why this is popping out of here. Let's see if there's anything broken. I don't see anything broken or even wore down. At least on that side. It could be on this side too. Let's see, it would be. Right here. That looks fine there too. We got some dirt and stuff on here, but yeah, the plastic looks okay. So if there would have been some, you know, chips or something like that, I could see why maybe it was popping out. But I don't know. I think maybe it just got dropped. It does get dropped quite a bit, and that's usually the problem with it. So let's go ahead and move on to why the trigger's not working. Make sure we're still in frame. See, even though I have that zip tied, it's still kind of a pain in the butt to deal with. But it's better like that than it is all sprawled out, for sure. So we gotta check for cuts in the wire. So we have a ground that's spliced here and here. No, just here. Can't tell if it. Yeah, that looks like something I did. And all looks okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to check the micro switch just to make sure it's... I can hear it, but that, like I said, it doesn't mean anything. Okay, so we're reading continuity. Oh, I'm touching my stupid leads together. I'm going to say, why are we reading now? Okay, now we're okay. So I'm thinking maybe it just needed adjusting. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that's probably fixed. Put this game back together, and then we'll head out to the floor and maybe get some gameplay if it's early enough. All right, let's see if it works.
Open season. Or how do you cook?
Actually, I forgot to put the lens back in.
Welcome to Whitetail Adventure. Pick a spot.
Maybe it won't work without the lens.
Nice shot.
Gets it. We'll do some full gameplay next time. All right, let's get a little gameplay. This is the next day. I put the gun back together and I forgot to put the lens in the end of it. And it played, it worked, but not very well. So waited till I had a chance, which was tonight. Got it back in. It does work, so now I'm just gonna have a little gameplay. Played once earlier, they're pretty good. Playing Safari, I never play this.
Welcome to Big Buck Safari Outback. Fire up the Bobby.
I don't think many other people play it either. Or at least since redid the hard drive, so I need to reset all the high scores.
Welcome to Kudu Adventure.
I like this one because of the trophy animal at the end, so you get to shoot four things. I'm not really big on shooting elephants, but this in a video game, I don't really care. Oh, come on.
That's one. You have two.
Not used to these things.
You've done well.
Somebody plays this one. I was getting Hunter Hero on the other one every time. Scores on this game all over the place. Like I
I said, I never played a Safari. Trophy animal's hard to get. Hopefully you can hear me. I like to mumble a lot.
You are the new hunter hero.
Yeah. It's actually a decent score. One more. Still a hunter.
Oh, I got two.
Alright, here's where I get horrible on the bonus game. And a little gameplay.
Thanks for watching, and hopefully we don't have to visit this gun again for a little while.
So these two right here are going to be ground and 5 volt. So what do we get here? Did I not turn the game on? I didn't turn the game on. I guess that would help. Hang on.
Here it is. A nice little trade. The person I traded got what they wanted. I got what I wanted. And a pretty good deal on it, too.
Why did I get what I want?
That comes later.
Yeah.
Okay. It's on fire.
Wow.
Whoa. Lots of smoke.
Well, that's bad.
Yeah, well, thanks for watching.
When you take care of people, people take care of you in this community.
That's the truth.
So everyone, please remember that. Even if we're competitors, we're not enemies.